Welcome to the Paris911.com Real Estate Podcast with your host, Connor MacGyver, local agent serving the greater Los Angeles areas and greater headquarters in the Santa Clarita Valley.
Good day, everybody. Connor MacGyver, Remax's Paris 911 team. Welcome to the day after Father's Day. And it was quite a day. In fact, such a day that apparently I have caught my youngest son. He gave me a gift for Father's Day that it really means the world. I'm actually sick, have a sore throat, and difficult to swallow. So there we go. So that is the reason for my sexy bedroom voice this morning. Deeper than normal. By the way, if you don't know, if you're just tuning in here for the first time, we are Remax's Paris 911 team. We're headquartered here in the Santa Clarita Valley, serving greater Los Angeles with regard to real estate. We do have a team in place. We're under the Remax brokerage, and online you can always find us at Paris, P-A-R-I-S, 911.com. So that's going to be your entry point to see everything that is us and our team. Today, as you know, if you've listened before, today's Market Update Monday, so we should have those reports out here in the next few hours. What we typically do is we're going to post these up at realtor.paris911.com, realtor.paris911.com, but to keep it simple, K-I-S-S, keep it simple, silly, we can go just to the main website at paris911.com, punch into the Mac box at the top part of the screen, Market Updates, and get the latest intel how the local markets are doing. Now, if this last week is compared to the week before, as compared to the week before that, within the last few months, we're going to continue, potentially, to see the same trend we've been watching. Boy, I just stumbled right through that. That trend happens to be where we see big differences in the listing prices versus the sales prices. And throughout that scenario, from a time of properties listed, depending on the days on market time frames, we're going to see several reductions in that particular price until it sells. But the thing that we haven't seen is we haven't seen those median sales prices, not list prices, but the prices these properties actually sold for, that level, we haven't seen that reduce. Those have been flatlined across the Santa Clarita Valley cities and in also most of the greater LA areas. Now, if you take a city like Beverly Hills, that's totally an anomaly, the same as San Francisco. Those cities are really reporting a whole different scenario in a market. Currently, in the Santa Clarita Valley, greater LA areas, we happen to be in a seller's market. Sellers are still controlling the ball, but we've watched over the last 3 months, since the end of the first quarter, we've watched as that has started to shift a little bit. So about mid to end of March, we've started to notice that the market is starting to move into being more of a buyer's market and them controlling the ball. Now, it's not done yet. It's going to take a few more months for this to play out. One of the things that we're going to be looking for in order for this to happen would be more inventory. So let's watch for that. Also, an increase on days on market timeframes, DOM, days on market. That means it takes longer for properties to actually sell, get into escrow, and then successfully close escrow. We're going to also notice an increase in BOMs. Those are back on market properties, properties that were in escrow and then all of a sudden they are no longer in escrow. The reason why that happens a lot of the time, well, recently, the reason why we're seeing this more and more is buyers are out there, right? They're looking for properties. They find one. They fight for it, probably. It's probably not given to them easy, even though, you know, we're making the transition of the buyer's market. It's not a simple process for them to get their offer accepted. There's going to be some back and forth. It's not going to be, you know, you write the offer, get it accepted, open escrow. That's very much a rarity today, very rare in today's market. So they fought for it a little bit. They got it. They pulled the fish in the boat, and they're pretty happy with their catch regarding, you know, as pertaining to the home that they have purchased. However, then they are still what? They're still searching for real estate. They still see other properties coming onto the market. And what if something that better meets their needs comes onto the real estate for sale market? What do they do then? Well, we're seeing canceling escrow. However, would that have any negative consequences on a real estate buyer? Potentially. It depends on the time that it was canceled as far as within contract. What those terms they had signed off on or agreed to were. And if that's also going to depend on how safe and secure their deposit is. Ultimately, the biggest push from a real estate seller that has a buyer cancel escrow, if they believe that they've been injured or harmed, well, then they attorney up, right? Typically, it's going to be a mediation process first, and then they'll get into it. Typically, that's part of the contract where all parties, upon a falling out, everybody agreed to go to mediation arbitration. That has a direct impact, having that clause signed within contract on the E&O from the real estate company. Some companies actually mandate it. But again, if that's the type of company you're working with and you don't want to sign it, then you might have to move on. Just something to consider. But before you pull out of anything as a real estate buyer, be careful. And as a real estate seller, before you start to enforce anything, make sure your agent explains to you what was within contract that you signed and give you chapter and verse so you know how strong your case happens to be. Now, most real estate agents aren't attorneys. Some are. Just be careful. Make sure you're reading all the small print and make sure it makes sense to you. And then beyond that, if all parties start to arbitrate, mediate, and attorney up, you're going to definitely want to sit down with the one you're hiring and give them the A to Z to it. And I believe, well, I know for a fact, the real estate agent is going to be a huge part of that. All right. So that's our Market Mondays. One of the things that's been coming out, I've been watching this, we have a system that we put together, bestresidentialvalues.com. You can also get access via the same home evaluation system by going to scvequity.com. But anyway, here's how it works. When you're looking online, there's a lot of websites that are going to, when you punch in, let's say, your address, all of a sudden, what's at the top part of the SERPs, the search engine results pages, where you're going to see those Z-estimates by Zillow, you're going to see other websites telling you what your property or that particular address happens to be worth from their comparisons. That's a computer program, folks. That's not a top-producing real estate agent that knows what properties are going to be selling for and how that local market is. That's a computer system giving you what your property happens to be worth. And again, some of those, we've seen some of those online valuation systems for real estate, they've been off, you know, $100,000, $150,000, up or down, plus or minus, but we've seen that because it's not an expert salesperson saying, all right, this is what I could sell it for in today's market. And of course, the more an agent can sell it for, the more they make. So it would always behoove them to get that thing listed as much as possible to give the seller and themselves the best return. That's it. BestResidentialValues.com. Thanks for joining us on today's radio show. We appreciate it. We're going to get those market reports again. Market updates is what you type into the Mac box. I'm Connor McIver, Remax's Paris 911 team. It's always a pleasure. Thanks for listening to my sexy voice during our radio show, and we will talk to you very soon. Probably throw this up on YouTube later this afternoon as well. Connor McIver, Remax's Paris 911 team. Take care.